فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
But those are the six types that he comes in. Inshallah ta'ala, more details will come in the other kutubs that we're going to go through, inshallah ta'ala. More details will come there. Now we're going to move on to the next one, which is Amma Jam'u Mu'annath al-Salim. We know what Ism Mufrad is, right? We all know what Ism Mufrad is, right? We all know what Ism Mufrad is, right? Huh? We do, right, brothers? We also know what Jam'u Taksir is. I'm asking you brothers questions. We do. Good. Now inshallah ta'ala, we're going to move on to Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim. What is Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim? Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim, again, go to the sharh of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. He says, مَا دَلَّ عَلَىٰ أَكْثَرَ مِنِ اثْنَتَيْنِ. It is whatever shows you more than two females. بِزِيَادَةِ أَلِفٍ وَتَاءٍ فِي آخِرِهِ. With a what? With a what? Alif and a ta at the end. That's how it is. Well, in that case, some of the scholars, are you with me? They actually don't like calling a Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim. And they disagree with that usage. The reason is because it is Jama', it is Mu'annath, but it's not Salim. It's not Salim. Why? Salim means that the word from its original letter, when it came from the singular, and when it turns to the jama', it doesn't get tampered with. Does that make sense? For example, we have the word bint. We have the word bint. Sah? Of the word bint. Sah? What do we have? We have the word bint. Bint means what? One girl. Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim, if we use that term, what we mean is that all that's going to happen to the word is that alif and ta is going to be added to it. And this is not going to be tampered with. It's not going to be touched. Because the Jam'u al-Mudhakkar al-Salim is Salim, which we're going to see later. The plural masculine word is Salim, meaning it's safe from any alteration. The word Muslim, all you do is add a waw and noon at the end. Muslim, look at it. Muslimuna. It doesn't change. The haraka doesn't change. The shakl doesn't change. Look at what happens here. Bint. Hey, how do you make it Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim? Yeah? Banat. So you take the kasra off of it, the sukun goes again, and it becomes banat. And look, what happens here? What happened to this ta? It's gone. And so what happens? This word comes, and what does it do? All together. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? Yeah? So the word, is it salim from taghir? So it's not good to call it Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim then. Is it good to call it Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim? Scholars, they call it, instead of calling Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim, they call it Jam'u al-Mu'annathati al-Mazidatu Mazidatu bi-Alifi wa-Ta. That's what they say. Amma ma jumi'a bi-Alifin wa-Ta'in mazidataini. To be more precise. Ma jumi'a bi-Alifin wa-Ta'in mazidataini. You guys have the bottom of the kitab. What does it say at the bottom, the haqiqah at the bottom for you guys? What is that? Does it say al-awla an yuqala al-jam'u alladhi khutima bi alifin wa ta'in mazidatayn? Does it say that? Yeah? Does that make sense? So pay attention to that. So it's not good to call it that. Have you all understood that? That's what Jam'u al-Mu'annath al-Salim is. We're now going to swiftly, we're going to move on to what? Al-Fi'l al-Mudari'ah. الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. What does it mean فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء؟ It's the alif that is saved. It's the fi'l mudari'. We all know what fi'l mudari' is, right? We're going to study in more details, inshallah ta'ala. The fi'l mudari'. So he says al-fi'l mudari'. Let's break the term. Let's break the term up, inshallah ta'ala. What does it say? Al-fi'l mudari', right? We all know fi'l mudari'. Sah? Fi'l mudari' is anything that starts with the zawa'id al-arba'a. These four letters go before it. Alif, Noon, Ya, and what? Which we bring together, which is called anaitu, right? So the word daraba. Daraba. What do? The word daraba. If you put alif before it, or a noon before it, or a ya before it, or a ta before it, it becomes a fi'l mudari'. It becomes a present verb. Because these four letters are the Zawa'id al-Arba'a. Don't worry, it's going to come to us in more details. The book is going to go through it. But fi'l mudari', for what you need to know now, is a present verb. What is it? It's a present verb. So the author here goes, fi'l mudari'. What does it mean, الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٍ? الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٍ, what does it mean? Okay. It means, the word, يَضْرِبُ. Yad ribu. Because I put the word the ya from here, right? So it's a fi'l mudari' now, sah? It's a fi'l mudari', right? Is yad ribu a fi'l mudari' الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء? Yes, it is. Why? Because it's saved from three things entering it. Waw al-jama'a. Alif. Alif al-ithnain. And ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba. So if it becomes يضربون or يضربان or تضربين, what happens? It's no longer referred to as what? الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. Does that make sense? So as long as there's no alif or noon at the ending, as long as there's no alif and noon at the ending, or a waw and noon at the ending, or a ya and a noon at the ending. Does that make sense to you, brothers and sisters? It has to be saved from that. The Sharih, inshallah ta'ala, the author of the Kitab Al-Ajrumiyyah, he says it himself. He says, الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ بِهِ أَلِفُ الْإِثْنَيْنِ أَوْ وَاوُ جَمَعَةٍ أَوْ يَا مُخَاطَبَةٍ. Does that make sense? It has to be saved from these three. What are the three things that it has to be saved from? It has to be saved from, number one, Alif Uthnaini. Has to be saved from what? Alif Uthnaini. Aw Wawu Jama'a. Or it has to be saved from what? Wawu Jama'a. We mentioned it. Or it has to be saved from what? Aw Ya'a Mukhataba. Once it's saved from any of those three, then what does it become? It becomes the fi'l al-mudari' الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. Also, it has to be saved from something else. It also has to be saved from another thing, which is نون التوكيد خفيفة أو ثقيلة. It can't be connected to a نون التوكيد, which is whether it's خفيفة or whether it is ثقيلة, it doesn't matter. No نون التوكيد can matter. So for example, قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah, لا يسجنن وَلَا يَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ لَا يُسْجَنَنَّ. That's even worse than waw and noon, alif and noon, or ya and noon connecting to it. You know why it's worse? Because now it's actually left the realm of i'rab. It's now become mubni. It's no longer mu'rab anymore. And that's the two times when the fi'l mudari' becomes what? Becomes mubni. The asal is that the fi'l mudari' is what? The present verb, the asr, is that it's what? Mu'rab. The times that it becomes mabni is what? If nunu tawkid enters it, or nunu niswa, or nunu niswa, والوالدات يرضعن. The word يرضعن is مبني صح؟ is مبني. Are we all together؟ مبني على السكون. Am I making sense? No. I am? Very good. So what needs to be saved from it is that it can't be, these three can't connect to it. The فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء is meant by that واو النون ألف النون ياء النون cannot connect to it. Good. Also نون التوكيد or نون النسوة. And I told you لا يسجنن for example والوالدات يرضعن أولادهن حولين كاملين لمن أراد أن يتم الرضاعة. والوالدات يرضعن. The word يرضعن is it left the realm of إعراب. It's no longer معرب. It's now مبني. It's a whole different situation. So if it's saved from all of those, this one and this one, that's what's meant by الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. It has to come like this. يضرب يقتل يسمع. If it becomes يسمعون, it's not فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. We all together. No, it's a whole different situation. Where in بابو معرفة علامتي العراب. That's the chapter that we're doing. We're doing بابو معرفة علامات العراب. We're not studying مبني. So we won't entertain the idea of what's مبني. How do you go? Just now it won't be. It will follow. What were the other words that are مبني? The فعل أمر and the فعل ماضي. So the فعل مضارع that has نون النسوة and نون التوكيد, it goes with its brothers. The فعل ماضي, it goes with it and it goes with the فعل مضارع. فعل ماضي and the حروف. That's where it goes down that road. نعم. What don't you understand? Okay. Jazakallah khairan for saying that. Brothers and sisters, if you don't understand, say, I don't understand. Study your talk to yourself. I'm more than happy to repeat. Basically, what the author is saying is when he says, فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء, is the فعل, in simple terms, is whatever فعل that doesn't have any waw and noon at the end, alif and noon, and what? I'm just saying noon, just because it's the majority of the times, but I'm not being precise by saying noon. Really what you need to look at is waw and alif and noon. So for example, yadribuna. Yadribuna. Okay, question. The word yadribuna, hey? Is it فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء? Yeah. Is it? يضربون is the فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. It's not. Why is it not? Because what does it have at the ending? It was meant to be what? يضربوا. Okay? That's what we're talking about. Any word, if you find waw and noon at the end, or if you find at the end what? Alif and noon. Or if you find ya and noon. If it becomes yadribani or tadribani, it can't be yadri tadribina. I have to change it to ta because it's what? Ya al mu'annathat al mukhataba. Does that make sense? Am I making sense now? That's what shouldn't happen. And there's another thing that shouldn't connect to it. After these three, there's another thing that the author wants you not to, is that Nun al-Tawqid and Nun al-Niswa. So this is these three, and also Nun al-Tawqid and Nun al-Niswa. They also shouldn't connect to the ending. Nun al-Tawqid is the Nun that has a shadda on it. Are we together? Or the Nun of emphasis. And Nun al-Niswa is the Nun that indicates that this is women. Okay? And we will study more about what's Nun al-Tawqid and what's Nun al-Niswa. They will come to us. Because if the فعل مضارع نون التوكيد ونون النسوة connects to, what does it become? It becomes مبني. And this is the only two times when it becomes mabni, right? The two times when the fi'l mudari' is mabni is when? When nunu tawkid and nunu niswa connect to it. That's just a side point that you need to realize. In other words, in simple terms, فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء is as long as it's not أمثلة الخمسة. Or as long as it's not أفعال الخمسة. Does that make sense? But then you would say, what is أفعال الخمسة? So I just explained. Does that make sense? That's all it really is. As long as it's not أفعال الخمسة. Because what we just wrote in right now, يضربون تضربون يضربان تضربان تضربين. What is that? أفعال الخمسة. So فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء is as long as it's not أفعال الخمسة. You've just learned أفعال الخمسة. أفعال الخمسة is the opposite of فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. It's what finishes with واو النون, ألف النون, and ياء النون. Does that make sense? The grammarians, the nuhat, the grammarians, they say that it shouldn't be called أفعال الخمسة. This is a khata, it's a mistake. You know why? Because if you say أفعال الخمسة, people would think you're trying to say that these are only five verbs. When really, these five, which is يفعلون, يفعلاني, يفعلاني, تفعلاني, يفعلون, تفعلون, تفعلين, they are symbols of every verb that you can use it for. It's a representative of all the other verbs. They're not only these five. Are we together? Whereas asma'ul khamsa is abuka, akhuka, hamuka, fuka, dhu malin. These five. Are we all together? That's a side point where we don't want to go into that right now. It's not our field of discussion. Am I making sense? No. Am I? So what it should be called correctly is amthilatul khamsa. It's better to call it amthilatul khamsa instead of calling it af'alul khamsa. Okay, Allahumma ista'ana ala ma tasif. Are we all on the same page? Look, brothers and sisters, when you're studying grammar, don't ever expect yourself to understand it the first time straight away fully. It shouldn't be. It's not the case. It's not meant to be. It's meant to be, you go over that lesson again and again, and you have more questions, and you understand, and you learn. If you try to understand it like somebody who's been studying it for so many years, then are you going to... No. Are we all together? Somebody's been doing it for so many years, you've just started learning the grammar now, you're going to feel a bit, okay, it's hard for me. And that's what it is. Everything that you, for the first time, it's a bit tricky until you get the hang of it. Sah Imran, how many times did you do ajrumi with me? 6 times. I don't know. Do you find it now easy? Flows? This part flows, okay. The last part is problematic for you. But are we all together? Does that make sense? 6 times, and he still thinks the last part of the book is a bit complicated for him. Are we all together? Okay, now we're going to go into the other type, which is Jam'u Mudhakkar Salim. Jam'u Mudhakkar Salim. What does Jam'u Mudhakkar Salim mean? Jam'u Mudhakkar Salim is ismun dalla ala akthara min ithnaini. It is a noun that shows more than two. Masculine. More than two masculine. Or two male. More than it. بِزِيَادَةٍ فِي آخِرِهِ. With the additional adding on the ending. صَالِحٌ لِلْتَجَرُّدِ عَنْ هَذِهِ الزِّيَادَةِ. صَالِحٌ لِلْتَجَرُّدِ عَنْ هَذِهِ الزِّيَادَةِ. What does he mean by صَالِحَةٌ لِلْتَجَرُّدِ عَنْ هَذِهِ الزِّيَادَةِ? What does he mean? Can anyone guess? No. What it means is that the word Muslimuna, it is befitting, it can be possible to strip off the waw and the noon of it, the waw and the noon of the word, and it will still stand appropriately. It's like a word that exists. It will still be a word, Muslim. Muslimuna. If you take the waw and noon off it again, what does it turn back to again? So it is salih. It is appropriate. للتجرد عن هذه الزيادة, to strip off this. So in other words, when you strip it off, if it has no meaning, it's like a word that doesn't exist, then it becomes mulhaq. That's what mulhaq is. This is that point that the salih al-tajarrud is what distinguishes it from mulhaq. For example, what's the word? What's the word? Muslim. 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 This is also salih al-tajarrud. Are we all together? The word has Muslim, it's Muslim. 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 What do you say now together, all of those? When you want to talk to all of them at the same time, what do you call them? Male. Muslim. Muslim. I didn't say Muslimah. I said Muslim. Not Muslimah. Muslim, Muslim, Muslim. What do you say? Muslimuna. That's what you say, right? This is salih al-tajarrud. Okay. Can I take the word and use the same like it with it? Can I do atf of another word like it? So can I say, Ja'a al-muslimuna salihuna? Can I say that? So I'm using jam' dhakr salim with another jam' dhakr salim. That's what the author means here. وَعَطْفِ مِثْلِهِ. The likes of it, you can do atf with it. You can say and. Am I making sense? Good. Very good. Very good. Does everyone know? Do you all know what? Everyone know what jam' dhakr salim is? And the ziyada is alif and noon. Waw and noon. And ya'u and noon. Waw and noon. And a ya' and noon is a ziyada that adds on to the jam' dhakr salim. So it's muslimuna or muslimina. Muslimuna or muslimuna. What's the difference between muslimuna? And what's the difference between muslimina? The difference is, مسلمون is حالة الرفع مسلمين is حالة النصب والجر حالة النصب والخفض. We'll come to that. Don't confuse yourself right now. Good. Now we're going to go into the five sisters. He goes, وَأَمَّا الْأَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ. As for the أَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ. But is it five or is it six? Or is it seven? It's six. Why did he mention here five for you? Because you're a baby. You're a baby. You're only told what you need now. And there's another reason why he didn't mention this one. There's another reason why he never mentioned it. The other reason, we're going to study that in Mutamimatul Ajumiyah. But it's six. Six. He left it deliberately. He says, وَأَمَّا الْأَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةُ فَهِيَ هَذِهِ الْأَلْفَاظِ الْمَحْصُورَةِ الَّتِي عَدَّهَا الْمُؤَلِّفُ وَهِيَ أَبُوكَ وَأَخُوكَ وَحَمُوكَ أَمَّا وَحَمُوكِ وَفُوكَ وَذُو مَالٍ. The word حَمُوكِ is used for the woman's family. Are you with me? أَبُوكَ is your father. أَخُوكَ is your brother. حَمُوكَ is what? Your in-laws, the girl, is used for the woman, the woman's in-laws. Are we? They're the man's family. So that's why when we say hamuki, we never say hamuka. It's wrong to say hamuka. Yeah? Ghalad. It's meant to be? Hamuki. Fuka means what? Fuka is your mouth. Dhu malin, we don't like wealth, we don't want to connect people to wealth, so we say dhu ilmin. Sah. We want to connect people to knowledge and the importance of knowledge. Sah. So we don't say dhu malin. Sah. وَمَا هَذِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ وَلَهْوٌ وَزِينَةٌ وَتَفَاخُرٌ بَيْنَكُمْ وَتَكَاثُرٌ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ. We want people to know the sharaf and the importance of knowledge. So we say dhu ilmin, we change that little point. Those are five. The five sisters, are we all together? So abuka means your father, akhuka means your brother, hamuki means your in-laws, fuka means your mouth. Dhu means, whatever you possess is called dhu, the possessor of this. Okay? Dhu means possession of something. Sahib. Okay. This one we're going to have to stand over for a little bit longer than the rest. Okay? And I can see your brains are not ready for it, so we'll do it next week, inshallah ta'ala. We'll do it next week. There are conditions for the shurutu i'rab al-asma al-khamsa. There are two shurut which is amna, they all have in common. And shurut which is khasa, specific types of condition to what? Dhu and fu. Dhu and fu, they have a specific conditions for them. I will speak about those conditions inshallah ta'ala next lesson bi'idhnillahi al-bariyu. Anything which I've said that was wrong, mistakes, shortcomings, is for me, and shaitan and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.